Hey everyone, and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion, and the action of the infraspinatus muscle. The infraspinatus is one of the four rotator cuff muscles of the shoulder. The other three being the supraspinatus and the teres minor. If we're to take an anterior view, we can also see the last rotator cuff muscle, the subscapularis. So let's move back to a posterior view again, and we can see here the spine of the scapula. The spine of the scapula is an important landmark to remember, as it helps us memorise the name and location of the infraspinatus. The infraspinatus sits inferior to the spine of the scapula, infraspinatus, inferior to the spine of the scapula. Above it, we have the supraspinatus, and you can guess it sits superior to the spine of the scapula. So let's remove the other rotator cuff muscles and take a look at the origin and the insertion of the infraspinatus. In red here, we can see the infraspinatus sits in the infraspinatus fossa. And in blue here, we can see that the infraspinatus inserts on the greater tubercle of the humerus. So one of the interesting things about the infraspinatus is that you're able to see it from the skin surface. So you can see right here a bodybuilder, and he has a large amount of muscular development as well as a low body fat percentage. This allows us to quite easily see the infraspinatus right here. If the individual was a greater body fat percentage or had quite a lot less muscular development, you might not be able to see the infraspinatus so easily from the skin surface. So we're back here again with the skeleton model, and you can see the origin of the infraspinatus here in the infraspinatus fossa and the insertion on the greater tubercle of the humerus. So it's connecting the two of these, and as it squeezes or flexes, it's going to externally rotate the shoulder because it's going to be squeezing, pulling it together. So external rotation. See on myself, externally rotating the shoulder. You can see some slight extension of the shoulder there as well when the infraspinatus is performing its task. Another action of the infraspinatus, when the shoulder is abducted like that, it's going to squeeze and adduction, just like that. So we got squeezing the infraspinatus, it's adducting my humerus. Now it's important to remember the infraspinatus forms part of the rotator cuff muscles, so it's not performing all these actions in isolation. It's working together with all the other rotator cuff muscles to stabilize this humerus in the glenohumeral joint. So if you like the video, you know which buttons to press. Press all those buttons. And I'll see you all in the next video.